Greetings, beloved. Welcome to the Book of Remembrance. This message was received from the Lord Jesus on December the 27th, 2015. The title of the message is Judgment on America, the Harlot. And the Lord Jesus began, I am rich in mercy and grace. Seek mercy and grace while it is yet to be found. Judgment is coming soon. How long must I plead with you, O hard-headed ones? Will you listen when the sword takes over your land? Is that what you need in order to pay attention to my voice? Is violence the catalyst you require to spring you into action? I have pleaded with you in times of quiet and peace. And what have you done? You have turned up your nose at me and walked away from me, O America. I have blessed you with intelligence, wealth, peace, and long life. From you have come many marvelous inventions. Your people have prospered exceedingly. Your poorest are richer than the rich people in some countries in Africa. You have not had a war in your country in decades, and many of you live to an old ripe age. Every blessing that I promised you, I have given to you. I have not withheld anything from you. Your blessings were heard of all over the world, and many sought refuge and a piece of your blessing in your land. You opened your arms and welcomed them. They came in with their cultures and their gods. They partook of your wealth and grew fat and rich, but they did not abandon their gods. But you, America, you abandoned your God. Has it ever been heard that a nation would trade its true God for one fashioned by human hands? But you have accepted their impotent gods and their impotent ways, and have gone to suckle at the breasts of a dried-up cow. You have exchanged me, the one who blessed and increased your influence. You have exchanged me for dead gods, images of demons, and the devil himself. You have used that which I blessed you with to offer sacrifices at his altar of abominations. You have offered your own children to Moloch by shedding their blood at the altar of abortion. You have sold your children and teenagers to the sexuality of ancient Rome. The molestation of children is increasing. Children are made aware of sexuality long before it is their time to discover it through the abominations of the pornography industry. Your men seek vile, unnatural sexual practices. They willingly offer their own women to other men and watch as they are defiled. The women have forgotten purity and pursue fleshly lusts without shame, sleeping with one man after another, sometimes two or three at the same time. You bring your vile lusts home to your children, who then follow suit. You have so confused your own children to the point that they do not know the difference between right and wrong. Your sexual lusts are no longer human or even animalistic. Instead, they are demonic. And worse still, you seek even viler lusts. Your thirst for the filth of sexual sin simply increases with age. Older men now have no shame having sex with children. Older women pursue children young enough to be their grandsons and granddaughters in order to fulfill a carnality that is straight from hell. Indeed, the ancient sexual sins of Rome have been revived. Homosexuality is increasing. Bisexuality is increasing. Bestiality will soon show its ugly head. It seems nothing is taboo anymore. These were the very sins that destroyed Rome. They exported their sins everywhere they went and corrupted many peoples and cultures, the very same way that America is doing now. You export abortion, homosexuality, swinging, pornography, and lewd language like they're commodities to be exchanged in the open market. Do you seriously believe that you'll get away with this madness unscathed? Do you think I will ignore the corruption that you have exported abroad? The people you have corrupted and cultures you have destroyed with your filth? Oh no, America, that which you have sowed, you will reap sevenfold. Corruption of culture is just the tip of the iceberg. You have exported war and disease worldwide, and yet you sit there calmly as if you have done nothing wrong. Though you seek to expel me from your midst, from your country, yet I will not leave. No. I will make you drink from the same cup you have made other nations drink from. I will bring judgment on you, and you will know misery like you cannot imagine. All that you have exported will come back to you sevenfold. I will bring you down to your knees, O America. I will press your face down into the mud and make you drink every last drop and dredge from the very same cup you use to measure out corruption to the world. I will mete out a punishment so severe, the whole world will shake their head and lament at your downfall. I will prove to the whole world that I am still God over you, even as I proved to Egypt that I was God over all their false gods in the 10 plagues. I will send plague after plague of judgment upon you until you humble yourself and cry out for relief. You will either seek me or reject me, depending on which camp you belong to, but I will continue to strike you till you are diminished before the eyes of the whole world. Your former glory will be forgotten, because the severity of your judgment will obscure all that you ever prospered in. Be ready, America. A sword comes after you. The sword of Ishmael is held up against you, and it will strike you with a terrible vengeance. You have called me impotent and dead, but I will prove to you that it is you who is impotent and dead. I will divide your land with violence, and you shall watch in horror as all that you have gloried in is taken away from you. I am the Lord God Almighty. I am Yahweh, and I have spoken. Listen and turn from your wickedness, that you and your family may be saved, for judgment will not tarry long, and I will not withhold my hand. Judgment is set, and it will scourge your land and your people. Salvation is only available for individuals and families who seek me now for mercy and forgiveness. Those who repent and turn away from their wickedness now will be saved. The nation is doomed, and judgment will not be reversed. Like Sodom and Gomorrah, it will be destroyed. Only the repentant ones will escape. Yet even in their escape, many will lose all they ever had and will have to depend totally on me. He who turns back, remember Lot's wife. I love you, but I will strike you with my rod of judgment. A sword is over you, and it will bring much pain and misery. Let those who have an ear hear my words. This testimony is true in its entirety, and judgment is firmly set to burst out over America. And that was the end of the message. Brothers and sisters, let's take time to pray for one another. The Lord has set judgment upon America. Let's pray for America that He may have mercy, that He may have much mercy. Amen.